have already learned about the forms of verbs, right? Forms of helping verbs. We have learned about different forms of helping verbs or auxiliary verbs like do forms, be forms. In other words, I can say in terms of using family, like be family, have family, can family, will family, and many other helping verbs we have learned, right? Now we are going to learn one by one, like one family we are going to learn in this video only, okay? So in this video you are going to learn about the be family helping verbs or be form helping verbs. Why does it have has a two name? Because in class 4 you are going to learn this in the name of be family. If you go class 5, so in class 5 you are going to learn this verbs in the name of be forms only. So both are same only. So let's learn about be family or be form verbs, okay? So it means what? So be forms verbs or be family verbs are referred to the helping verbs only. Helping verbs, it is also called as auxiliary verbs, okay? So this auxiliary verbs, this helping verbs helps to helps the main verb to form the sentence, or it is also used to talk about the time of an action we learned, am I right? So now let's learn about what are be family verbs or what are be form verbs and what where can we use them, okay? Where can we use these be family verbs only, okay? So here be family or be form verbs are every verbs, every family, like have family, do forms, do family. So all these has a two types, that is present time and past time. They always tell us the present time as well as the past time. So let's learn about the present time verb and past time verb. So already I said it is used to talk about the time of an action, whether it has happened in the present or in the past. So let's learn about the present time verb, okay? Before that, let's learn what are be family verbs or be form verbs. So be forms verbs are am, is, are, was, where. There are 5, okay? I repeat again, am, is, are, was, where. These 5 verbs are the be family verbs or be form verbs, okay? So let's learn about the present time. In the 5 verbs only am, is, are the present time verb. So what are the present time verb here? Yes, am, is, are. These 3 things are the present time verb, and was, where are the past time verbs, okay? Was, where are the past time verb. So what is present time verb? Present time verbs help us to tell the action which is happening now. If the action is happening now, we will use these verbs to talk about the present time. So if you find any of this word in a sentence, means what? It talk about the present time only, we can easily identify. If you find was or where in a sentence, then it's talk about the past time only, we can identify it easily. Clear, children? So now let's learn about the present time verb, okay? So present time verb are am, is, are. These 3 things are present time verb. And for what are the subject, we need to use this am, is, are. Let's learn it, okay? So let's learn about am first, okay? Let's learn about the helping verb, that is auxiliary verb am. So when we are using helping verbs, like when we are using the be form verbs in a sentence, we need to add ing to the main verb. What is main verb? Yes, it is an action word, okay? To the action word we need to add ing if you are using this be form verbs in a sentence. So remember that whenever you are using be form verbs, that is am, is, are, or was, where in a sentence, you need to add ing to the main verb. So main verb are the action words like play, eat, drink, sleep, read, write. So those things are the action words. So when we use this be form verbs in a sentence, we need to add ing after the main verb, okay? So let's learn about the first verb, that is am. So where can we use am? Am is the present time verb. It can use only to the subject I. Remember that the verb am can be used only to the subject I only. So no other subject, we don't use this am, okay? Remember, always when we are talking about the present time event, there if you are talking about the subject I, then there will be the helping verb, that is am only. So am should be used only to the subject I. Okay, so here am is the be form verb. I already said when we are using this be form verb, we need to use the main verb, right? It will comes with the main verb only. Remember that always the helping verbs comes with the main verb. Here, which is the main verb? Yes, play is the main verb. Play is the main verb. You can notice that I have written ing after the main verb. Here, main verb is play. After writing play, I have added ing. Why? Yes, when we are using the helping verb am or be form verb, we need to add ing to the main verb. Here the main verb is play. Play is an action word. So after writing play, I need to add ing. So when I'm saying I am playing now, means I am play. It's not a complete sentence. You have to add ing. I am playing. Okay, I am playing now. Okay, so am can be used only to the subject I. That you have to remember it. Okay, and when we are using these be form verbs, we need to add ing after the main verb. Okay, now let's learn about is. Okay, where can we use the be form verb is? Okay, to the subject he, she, it, and also to the singular noun. Is can be used to the subject he, she, it, or to the singular noun. So if you find any subject which start with he or she or it, or you are talking about only one person in singular noun, it may be a single person, a single animal, a single bird, there you need to use is. Okay, is can be used to only to this subject only. And when we are using is, there should be a main verb which ends with ing. See the example. He is playing now. I am telling that he is playing now. He represents one boy. Okay. He is playing now. She is playing now. She represents one girl. It is playing now. You should not say me like it is play. It is play now. That is the wrong way of saying it. Okay. So it is, when we use is in a sentence, there should be ing after the main verb, that is playing. It is playing. I mean any singular noun, like Ravi is playing now. Okay, Sheila is playing now. Okay, a bird is flying. A bird is flying. I said only one bird, so is a bird is flying. So when we use the be form verbs, there we need to add ing to the main verb. That you need to remember it. Okay, clear children? So where do we need to use the verb is? Yes, after the subject he or she or it or any single person, singular noun. It may be a single one person or one boy or one girl or one bird or one animal. Okay, so when we are talking about those one thing, that we need to use is only. Okay, then what about are? A-R-E-R. Where can we use A-R-E-R? Okay, are can be used to the subject, that is we, you, they, and also to the plural nouns. Are can be used to the subject after we, you, they, and as well as the plural noun. So for all the plural nouns to this present time, we use are only. A-R-E-R. It can be used to the plural nouns only. See, we means many persons, you also many persons, and they also the many persons. So when we are talking about the many thing, many persons, there we need to use are to the present time, and we need to add ing to the main verb as it is. Okay, so it will be like we are playing, you are playing, they are playing, and any plural nouns like two boys, Raju and Suresh are playing. Okay, Geeta and Preeta are playing. Okay, two dogs are playing in the street. So when we are talking about the plural for the present time, we need to use are. We need to use are only. Clear, children? So where do we need to use am? Yes, only to the subject I. Only to the subject I, we need to use am only. So I am playing. He is playing. This can be used to the single person. Okay, single person. It may be one boy or one girl or one animal or one thing or one bird. There we need to use is only. He is playing. She is playing. It is playing. Or any one person name. Okay, any one person name we can use is only. Okay. Then what about are? Are can be used to the subject. Are can be used to the subject we, you, they, and also to the plural nouns. So are can be used after the subject we, you, they, and also to the plural nouns. Okay. So after writing are, we need to add ing to the main verb. Okay. We need to add ing to the main verb. That is, we are playing. You are playing, they are playing, then any plural nouns like Ramesh and Suresh are playing, Ramesh and Ramya are playing, so any two dogs are playing in this state. So for the plural nouns in this present time, we need to use are only. Okay children, so let's learn some example. Okay, I have written one example. You have to guess and tell me what we need to put here. Okay, which verb should be suitable for this dash, okay, for this blank. She dash writing her homework now. She dash is writing her homework now. So it's talk about the present time. Or for she, which verbs we need to use? Do we need to use am or is or are? Which verb should be suitable for the subject she in the present time? Yes, you can check. Am should be used to the I only. Is can be used to he or she. So she, for she we need to use is only when we are talking about the present time. So the answer is his. Is, she is writing a homework now. I hope you are clear with this present time verb, children. I'll see you in the next video. Thank